Welcome to this magics tutorial about fixing STL errors. In this tutorial, we will discuss some of the basic fixing techniques in the Materialise Magics software. Fixing is a crucial step in a data preparation for 3D printing, since we need an STL without any errors for printing. Before showing you the fixing tools in Magics, we will do a short recap of the most common errors. The first error is the inverted normals. These errors arise when a normal of a triangle points in the opposite direction. The second error is bad edges, which can be categorized as near bad edges and bad contours. Near bad edges are edges that lay close to each other but are not fully connected, while a bad contour is a close loop of bad edges, often forming a hole in your model. The third error deals with shells, which is a cloud of uninterrupted triangles. A distinction between noise shells and intersecting shells can be made. Noise shells are very small in volume or in number of triangles and cause problems during printing. Intersecting shells are shells that partially occupy the same volume. Lastly, intersecting triangles and overlapping triangles are possible STL file errors. Both errors are usually not crucial to fix, but it is possible that they affect the quality of the printed part. In the following steps, we will explain some of the fixing techniques that can be used in Materialise Magics. An important and powerful tool for fixing is the Fix Wizard, which can be found on the leftmost side of the Fix ribbon. This automatic tool will in many cases be sufficient to fix the STL errors in your design. As you open the wizard, the first screen we will go to is Diagnostics. On this page, you get an overview of what is wrong with your STL file. Just press the Update button to bring the diagnostics up to date. The number of all found errors will be pointed out. The Fix Wizard will now advise you which actions or steps need to be taken to fix the STL errors. The advice serves as a guideline throughout the entire fixing process and can be seen at the top of the page. We can very easily adopt this advice by simply clicking on Follow Advice. Once done, the advice window tells us to click on Automatic Combined Fixing. You can also click on Follow Advice to get the same result. In this first step, there has been applied a combined fixing with a stitching parameter of 0.13 mm. It also advises us to go back to the diagnostics page to continue. Let's do this by clicking on Follow Advice. It directs us to the diagnostics page and will do an update of the errors. Again, we look at the advice window. This will guide us to the next step. In this specific case, the Fix Wizard suggests to go to the triangle page in order to continue solving the remaining errors. Just by pressing Follow Advice, we will be redirected to that page in the advice. In the triangle page, we will try to solve problems with bad edges and intersecting triangles. Clicking on Follow Advice will give you the automatic fixing for that error. Simply doing so, we can solve all errors with one click. Again, press Follow Advice. In between every automatic fixing step, via the Follow Advice button, the wizard will redirect us to the diagnostics and give us an advice on the next step. There are only 4 triangles left. The advice is to go to the overlap page. We press again the Follow Advice button and got redirected to the overlap page. Just by pressing Follow Advice, we will be redirected to the mentioned page in the advice. We will do so. Now we got into the overlap page. By clicking again on Follow Advice, we are executing an automatic fixing for these errors. This means that we could solve everything automatically up till this point. If the automatic fixing doesn't give the desired result, we can do some manual fixing. In this case, we will first need to detect the overlapping triangles. The detected overlapping triangles will get marked. Let's take a better look at these overlapping triangles. As you can see, a zigzag in the surface causes overlaps, and there are several ways to solve this problem manually. We can delete these specific triangles and fill up the hole. We can change some parameters related to the detection of sharp triangles. Or we can use the tools translate or move part points. I will use the last one. We will take a point on the mesh surface. We hold a point and drag it to another point on the mesh. A simple drag and drop moved the position of the triangles and could solve the remaining four overlapping triangles. So remember, in each step, you can choose to click on Follow Advice, which will give you the execution to an automatic fixing. By doing so, Materialise Magics will fix the errors automatically. In some cases, the automatic fixing button will not be able to fix all errors, or the results won't match the desired result. That's the moment manual fixing techniques can prove useful. The manual fixing functions can be found in the Fix Wizard, or on the Fix Ribbon itself. I hope you got a better understanding of the fixing tools used in Materialise Magics. Thank you for watching. If you would like to find more about the software, watch our other tutorials or go to materialise.com.